Previously on Linux for Everyone.
Jason finds himself.
Gotta stop referring to myself in the third person.
You're watching another installment of Will It's Linux! I can't do that with a straight face. So here's the scene. What was that squeak?
Alright, hold on.
No. No. Slayer, over here. Come on. Hey. Too much. Hey.
Oh, hi, everybody. Welcome back to Linux for Everyone, and welcome home. I've been wanting to say that for almost 3 years. I started this video with that short collection of bloopers as a reminder to you, but especially as a reminder to myself of how much fun running this channel used to be, because Linux is fun. There is inherently so much joy and excitement in discovering awesome new things about it, you know? And I sincerely miss doing that. I miss the process of sharing all of that stuff with you. The last proper video that I uploaded here was in April of 2022. It feels like an eternity ago. The Steam Deck was in its infancy, and the flood of PC gaming handhelds that it inspired, like the ROG Ally and the Legion Go, didn't even exist yet. Neither did distros like Bazite. NVIDIA was a month or two away from debuting its first open source GPU kernel modules. I remember reading about that and checking the sky for pigs flying overhead. You know what else hadn't happened yet? Windows 10 hadn't reached the end of its life, and Microsoft hadn't introduced the privacy hellscape known as Windows Recall. So the big question in the room has to be, why revive this channel now? Pretty much everything in my life has changed since 2022. But over the last few years, I've been watching from the sidelines, and I've seen the Linux world continue to evolve, as it always does. And I'm seeing exactly what I saw when I first discovered Linux and started using it back in 2018. All kinds of improvements that come at a shockingly fast pace. A passionate community, absolutely exploding with energy, contributing their time and their money to keep interesting projects alive and thriving. I've also seen the same gatekeeping, the same toxicity, and the same misinformation. Basically, there's still work to do, and I feel a calling to continue doing some of that work. There are new stories to tell and new projects to share. There are people who need to hear about Linux without being overwhelmed by all the power user jargon, the negativity, the distro warmongering, all of that crap. I always tried to make Linux for Everyone a positive and friendly voice in the sea of Linux content out there, and I definitely don't plan on changing that approach. So this is a fairly short video. They won't all be, of course. And I'm obviously not quite camera ready yet in my living space. But I wanted to get this out there. I had to get this out there. So let me close this one out by asking for your feedback. I have a bunch of ideas. I'm already working on the next video, but I would love to hear what you guys think is missing from the world of Linux coverage right now. What gaps are there that need to be filled? What projects, what apps really deserve a spotlight? And also, how the hell have you been? Until next time, take care and take care of each other. I'll see you soon.